We find Dvorak at the beginning of 1884 looking to make a statement. And he even writes about the symphony himself, and he says, it needs to be the most important statement that I have made. It needs to shake the entire world. On his daily walks to the train station, he sees these people that are arriving in Prague, that are getting ready to demand independence. He receives the commission to write the symphony from the London Philharmonic Society, and he sees this as the opportunity to finally make the right kind of statement for his people. We are equal. We are just as important as the great symphonists of the 19th century before him. So much of Dvorak's music sounds like just divine inspiration. To be able to create, to become the same kind of composer like the ones that he admired before, he had to find another way to write music. When we look at the symphony, we can tell that there's a lot more thought that goes into the building of the symphony. The symphony begins in the first movement with an introduction. There isn't really a melody, it's just creating an atmosphere. By the time we arrive at the moment in the music where it starts to sound like a melody, it's still very, very dark. It feels a little bit like you're part of a storm, the entire movement. At the very, very end, he comes back in a fast tempo. But he finishes the movement. Jum, 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 bum, bum, bum. He sets up the scene, he sets up the story, he sets up the character, and then he goes away to the second movement. Having just been through the death of his mother, having lost his eldest child as well, he brings this sadness and this pain that he feels. The third movement, like most of Dvorak's symphonies, have a very elegant and beautiful scherzo. He has the juxtaposition of the quasi-waltz rhythm or the waltz melody, but underneath it's a three-pulse rhythm, but in a way that it's very, very Czech and very much in the folklore of his people. We begin the finale with a statement that should be considered a little bit wrong. This is completely the wrong note in this tonality. He wants us to come back to this idea of the storm. He's not finished making a statement. You hear the trumpets in the distance, you hear the calls of the military march. The piece was premiered in 1885 in London, and it was an enormous success. It's beautiful, melodic, very intricate and interesting rhythmically. And then harmonically, it's always full of surprises. And these characters that are found in all of Dvorak's music, they now coexist as part of also the perfect form and the perfect structure in lines with the Brahms, with Beethoven symphonies before. He sees himself as having accomplished what he wanted to do, to create a statement that will shake the world. And this is what he did with the symphony.